Today in this video, I'm gonna show you how can you embed your Google's map location to your contact form. Especially you can use it in your contact us page, so it's gonna be fun. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. I have already created HTML and CSS file. In the index.html file, if I type exclamatory sign and hit that tab button, you will get this HTML5 boilerplate. For the title, I am giving embed Google map with contact form. Now inside the body tag, I am creating div with class name contact, and inside that div, I am creating another div with class name map. So inside this div will be Google's map location, and next to that div, let's create another div with class name form, and inside that div, I am creating h1 heading, and inside that I am writing contact us. So next to that, I am creating form element. For the action, we won't give anything. Now inside the form, let's create input element with type text. Similarly for the placeholder, I am giving name, and let's change that placeholder to email, and also let's change that type to email, and also once more let's duplicate this code. For the type, I am giving number. For the placeholder attribute, I am giving phone number. Now let's create another form element, text area. Let's remove all these attributes. Instead, I am giving placeholder. For the placeholder, I am writing message, and also next to that, let's create the button with type submit, and inside that button tag, let's write submit. Let's save this code. If you are in the VS Code and if you have installed the extension called Live Server, then in the index.html file, if you right click, then you will get the option called Open with Live Server. If you hit that option, it will open it in your default browser. Now you can see the output. Okay. You can see I have already created the style.css file, and inside that file, for the root sudo class, I have declared some default variables. Like for the primary, I'm giving dark pink color, and for the secondary variable, I have given their dark blue color. For the universal selector, I'm giving their margin and padding 0, and also for the box sizing, I have given their border box. Now let's link the CSS file. So just below the title tag, let's link our CSS file. So this style.css file, okay. Now let's adjust this screen. Now inside the style.css file, let's style our body tag. For the body tag, I'm giving height of 100 VH. Let's give display flex, and also justify content to center. Okay, now if I save, you can see there is no any changes. So first of all, let's style our div with class name contact. So for the class contact, I'm giving height of 70 VH. For the width, I am giving 75 VW. Now for the body tag, let's keep the align items to center. Now you can see there is changes in the output. Okay, now for the class contact, let's keep the box shadow. For the X offset, I am giving 0. For the Y offset, 0.2 rem. And for the blur, I am giving 0.5 rem. And also for the color, I am giving black color. At the end, I'm giving 6, so that 6 is the alpha value that controls the transparency of that color. Okay, now you can see in the browser some kind of shadow around the box. So for the body tag, let's give the background of gradient color. So for the body tag, I'm giving background image linear gradient. So for the angle, I'm giving 145 degree, and for the first color, let's give that secondary color. So let's write var, and inside that paste that secondary variable, and for the second color, let's give that primary variable. Okay, so that means dark pink color. So let's wrap it inside the var. Now if I save, okay, in the browser, now you can see. Okay, now for the class contact, let's give the border radius. I'm giving the border radius of 1 rem. Okay, in the browser, now you can see some rounded corner around the box. Similarly, now let's style this class map and also the class form. So they will be sharing the same CSS properties. So for that, I'm giving comma, okay. So class map, comma, class form. For the class map and the form, I'm giving width of 50% and also height of 100%. In the browser, now you can see. Now for the class contact, let's give the display flex. And also now let's style our class form. For the class form, let's give the background color. So I'm giving the background color of that secondary variable, dark blue color. You can see it in your browser. Now you can see that rounded corner is hidden. So if I give for the class contact overflow to hidden, now you can see the rounded corner around the box. Okay. Similarly, for the class form, let's give display flex, flex direction to column, and also justify content to space evenly. You can see in our final output, we have that arrow, okay, that pointed arrow. So in order to create that arrow, for the class form, I'm giving the before pseudo element. Now let's give the position of absolute. And for the class form, let's give position of relative. Similarly, now for the before pseudo element, let's give content empty, okay, nothing. This content property is compulsory, okay, otherwise you won't be able to create that before pseudo element. Similarly, let's give width of 0, height of 0, and for the border width, I'm giving 1.4 rem. For the border style, I'm giving solid, and for the color, I'm giving transparent. Similarly, let's duplicate this code, and instead of that border, let's give border right. So all the values are same, but let's change that color to, let's give that secondary color. Now you can see in the browser, but it is not in the proper position. So let's take it to the proper position. For that, I am giving top 10%, and also let's give left minus 1 rem. Okay, it's a bit low value, so let's give a bit higher value. I'm giving 2.5 rem. If I inspect this element, now let's change that 2.5 rem to 2.8 rem. This is exactly what you want. Okay, now let's style that H1 heading. So for the H1 heading, let's give the color of white color. Similarly, for the font width, I'm giving 500. For the font size, I'm giving 1.8 rem. And for the font family, let's give sans serif. In the browser, now you can see. Now let's style that form element. For the form element, I'm giving padding. For the top and bottom, I'm giving 0, and for the left and right, I'm giving 2 rem. And also let's give the same value for the H1 heading, okay. Now let's style this input element as well as the text area. For the input and the text area element, let's give width of 100%. And also let's give padding. For the padding, I'm giving 1 rem. Similarly, let's give the border. For the border width, I'm giving 0.08 rem. For the border style, let's give solid. And for the color, let's give that primary color. Similarly, let's give border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 2 rem. I want to remove that white background color. So in order to remove that white background color, I'm giving background color to unchecked. In the browser, now you can see. And also let's give the font color. For the color, let's give white color. So if I write something, you can see that white color text. Similarly, let's change that font size. For the font size, I'm giving 1 rem. Now let's give some space between the input elements. So for that, first of all, let's copy this code and let's paste it there. And let's write button. Now for the input text area and button, let's give margin top. For the margin top, I'm giving 0.8 rem. Okay, in the browser, now you can see there is some space between the elements. So for the first input element, we don't want to give that margin top. So for that, let's give the pseudo class not. And inside that, let's give the pseudo class first child. Now you can see this is what you want. So now let's style this submit button. So for the submit button, I want to give background color of that primary color. And also let's give padding. For the top and bottom, I'm giving 1 rem. For the left and right, let's give 2 rem. Similarly, let's give the color of that white color. Let's give the border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 2 rem. And also let's remove that border. So I'm giving border none. Okay, now you can see in the browser it's looking good. So for the text area, you can see we can resize and we haven't gave any height and width for that text area. So for that, now let's style that text area. For the text area, I'm going to give height of 7 rem. Okay, it's a bit big, so let's change it to 6 rem, and also let's give resize to none. Now it's time to embed our Google's map location. So in order to embed the Google's map location, first of all, if you visit the maps.google.com, then you will land in this page. Now let's search New York. Okay, now if I search the New York, now you can get this map. So something like this. Okay, so if I click, okay, I'm giving that location, and you can see Empire State Building. So you can see there are 5 buttons. So at the end, you can see there's a share button. When you click that share button, you can see pop-up box appears. So if you want to share the link, then you can copy that link, okay? But I don't want to do that. Rather, we want to embed this map, okay? So at the top, you can see another tab, embed a map. So if you click on that tab, you'll get the map, as well as there are other options, like if you want to get the small size, medium, large, or you know, you can give the custom size, but I want to keep it to medium. So if you press that copy HTML button, then your code is copied. Okay, so now in the index.html file, inside the dbwidth class name class map, so I'm pasting that code, the code that you have copied from that website. You can see there are so many attributes: style, width, height. I want to remove this width and height. We'll give the custom width and height with the help of CSS in the style.css file. Okay, before that, let's see the output. Okay, you can see small size of map. So in the style.css file, let's style that iframe. For the iframe, I'm giving width of 100%. And also for the height, I'm giving 100%. So if I save in the browser, now you can see, I think it's looking really good. Yeah, so there are different buttons. You can see plus, minus. So if I press plus, you can zoom. If I press minus, you can zoom out the map. If you want to change into dark theme, you can change. And if you want to view the map, you can press that view larger map. Okay, so you can view larger screen. Okay, so if I take it to the full screen, so remember, if there is no any internet connection, then you won't be able to see that Google map. Okay, you will see this no internet, so you need to have the internet connection. So now if you type in the form elements, something like coding design, for the Gmail I'm giving something like this, for the phone number let's give something, for the message you can give something like this. And okay, for the submit button, change that cursor. Okay, for the submit button, I am giving cursor to pointer. When you take your mouse to the submit button, now you can see that pointer icon. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.